सोने जैसे दिन है इसके, चांदी जैसी रात रे, उजला मुकुट हिमालय इसका और नदियों की माला है, पतवंदन करता श्रद्धा से नील सिंधु मत वाला है, अनुपम सुंदरता ने दी है सारे जग को मात्रे, एक बगीचा देश हमारा फूल अनेकों खिले यहाँ, अलग अलग है रूप रंग पर सभी प्रेम से मिले यहाँ, पतझड़ में भी मुस्कुराते इस उपवन के पात्रे, रंग बिरंगे पक्षी आकर गाते जागृति का गाना, नहीं किसी का हृदय दुखाते खाते मेहनत का खाना, नीले नक्शे होती है नित अमृत की बरसात रे, सच्चाई का यह आराधक है शांति प्रेमी नारा है, हिंसा का काले फन वाला नाग इन्हीं से हारा है।
Samarpan basically means offering all that you have. So it is a voluntary based organization. We started with a group of volunteers. Wherever there was a need for something to be done, the volunteers found means to go about implementing projects. The first project of Samarpan started because while driving a car one day, we were a couple of volunteers and we realized that there were some children on the streets who needed an education. So you started your own school, and that school started in 2007 and it's running very strong. As of today, 11 years hence, we have 800 children. So wherever there is a need, you go and you do what needs to be done without making a big deal.
So I joined Samarpan in 2009. At that time, Shraddha had already been running the school for 2 years. She wanted to use the building in the afternoon because it was rented for some other purpose. My landlady at that time had just retired as a principal of the government school and she wanted to start a tuition center. So we started the tuition center. Then I shifted my residence and she said that she could not run the, could not drive all the way here on her own. So I took over the tuition center. Then we shifted to these premises at that time. And this entire road was Kabariwala's go-downs. And the place used to stink. And I used to see these children on the road, nobody going to school. So I thought we can bring them to school for about 1 hour in the afternoon. And they refused. They said that our children are ill-treated in your schools and they tell us that you're dirty, your parents do dirty work, so we will never send. So we said that we are just here to come and stay, we come for 1 hour, that's all. So they agreed. So I said, I'm coming tomorrow to bring you to the school at 2 o'clock. When I reached there, in one of the godowns, they were shocked. They were not expecting me to come. And the children were running around, half-dressed, so some of them so excited, some of them terrified, hiding here and there. Then I just put out my finger, my hand, and I told one girl, hold my finger. I caught hold of her and I walked out. And I walked out, 3-4 children started walking. And as we walked from there to here, more and more children started walking, coming along. And like I felt like I was the Pied Piper. So that is my most memorable moment. So after 3 months, they settled down so well that we just shifted them into the morning school. They learned to be clean, neat, no more smelling. They are all going now to the senior schools also. No discrimination, nothing. Otherwise, it's very sad. Everything is very sad. These children have such sad lives. Fathers are alcoholics, they are bashing them up, there's so much domestic violence, there is so much anger in the children, there is so much, therefore, aggression. So we do a lot of value education, we talk to them a lot, you know. So it started as a sort of a play, informal school, main idea being to attract the children to come off the streets. Then they settled down well enough that by 2009 we could make it into a formal school following the NCERT syllabus. We were getting funding from one particular organization, but they have suddenly decided that they will not fund any NGO for more than 3 years. They want us to be self-sufficient, which is not possible for a free school. And plus we can't get community participation because they are also ignorant. They are also, the community here is illiterate. So it doesn't make sense. So now we're looking for funds elsewhere.
सबके घर में काफी सबके घर में तकलीफ है. ऐसा कोई बात नहीं कि किसी के घर में किसी बच्चा से परेशान है तो किसी पति से परेशान है. सबके घर में तकलीफ है ये बात नहीं है. बाकी कोई है कि नहीं कहता है कि हम अपने घर के बेइज्जती क्यों करें बाहर. वो तो सहना आप ही का है. हम सहते हैं बाकी फिर भी अपने सोचते कोई निकल के बाहर काम करता है इसलिए कि हमारे बच्चे हमारे परिवार थोड़ा वो रहे शांति रहे हमारे घर में. ऐसा नहीं है मैम. कोई कोई ये होता है कि नहीं निकल पाता अपने घर में रह जाता अपने परिवार के दुख तकलीफ सह के भी रह जाता. कोई नहीं सह पाता जिसके हुनर है या घर में कोई चीज़ सीख रखा है हाथ में या कोई चीज़ है वो बाहर अपना काम करता है. हमारे घर में भी बहुत परेशानी थी बहुत तकलीफ थी. फिर उसके बाद में मैं यहाँ पर आई. मेरी एक रिश्तेदार रहती है वो लेके आई थी मुझे. फिर उन्होंने मुझे यहाँ पुष्पा मैम के साथ लगाया. फिर मैंने ये सिखाया सिलाई सिखाई मशीन चलाना सिखाया सब कुछ सिखाया. थोड़ा बहुत ट्यूशन भी किया थोड़ा बहुत पढ़ना भी आ गया और आधा कम से कम आधा लगभग बैग भी आ गया है बनाना. मुझे आधा अभी नहीं बना पाती हूँ आधा बना लेती हूँ मैं. यहाँ सीख के मैंने बहुत कुछ सीखा है और बहुत गुण आ गया बहुत ज्ञान आ गया. अब खुद हम अपने बच्चों को भी देखते हैं पति को भी समझाते हैं. ये बात नहीं कोई चीज़ होता है तो बोलता है कि तुम बाहर निकल गई तुम्हारे बहुत बातें आने लगी. हम भी सोचते हैं हम भी तो इंसाने हैं. ये थोड़ी है कि हम पति के दाब में हमेशा दबे रहें. हम भी तो इंसाने हैं. जैसे वो बाहर निकलता है उसको हर चीज़ आता है. ऐसा औरत को भी सोचना चाहिए कि हम भी बाहर निकल के कुछ काम करें और कुछ सोचें आगे भी बढ़ें.
So after a couple of years of empowering children through education, initially we had a lot of resistance from the communities, from the families and from the parents. And I really mean a lot of resistance. It was only after over 4 years that the family started gaining trust and they didn't look at us that as if we had an ulterior motive. And what happened was a lot of women collected one day and they asked us if we could do something for them. That's the time. It wasn't with any great strategic planning. These are completely illiterate women. So we thought we could sort of impart training in stitching. So Archisha means ray of light. So it is just like shedding light in the darkest corners to bring a ray of light into every woman's life who requires it.
So what happened is when we first started, I was watching them working and she was sitting on the floor with the student and she was going like this, like that. So I asked her, what are you doing? So she said that she can't read the tape measure. So she was taking measurements with her fingers. So we started adult education for these people. Also. So they, at least they now can read the tape measure. They can do minimum calculation like dividing by quarter, by half and by four, which they need for cutting and all that. And they can sign their names. Then we opened bank accounts for them so that they could hide their money from their in-laws and husbands and, save money.
Adult education is not an option. You have to be. So you cannot say, oh, I can't do it. And there's no, it can be slow, it can be fast, but you have to be part of it. I mean, they're very scared because they've never gone to school or they've never learned.
So when I saw Sharna and Shraddha working here and the cause for which they were working was just so beautiful that I got drawn towards it, They basically, Archisha has been formed on the belief that if you raise the economic standards of the deprived and the ignored, you can actually build a civil society which has strong pillars. And the benefits that you get from it are enormous. So then I got attached to this place. So I just found out how I can help them out. So I head their design and marketing division here and help them design a few products which I can market for them. So when we say the marketing manager, I'm not just confined to the marketing manager here. So I come here, I volunteer here as a designer, I help them design, I source fabrics for them,
trends which would be marketable outside, then approach few stores like Jaipur, Fab India, Ugaan. Fab India has been working earlier also with us. And we do exhibitions, so I help them sell those products there. So the first USP of Archisha would be, I would say, is an all-women organization aimed at empowering women. I mean, that's the USP. But we specialize in making handicrafted goods like tote bags and jewelry, handcrafted jewelry, and few conscious clothing. And the other USP, I think, would be is we have a fair trade stamp. So wherein we see to it that the working conditions are as per the fair trade forum, and the minimum wages are paid according to the fair trade forum set. So the biggest impact that Archisha would have made in the lives of these women is bringing a smile on that face. You know, I have seen days when they are physically abused by their families. They have these days when they, you know, they are deprived of so many things. But when they come here, they find that happiness, they work, they get that sense of belonging. The financial independence that they get here and the joy of creating something, which is, you know, which is immense and cannot be measured. So we have different centers catering to different groups of women. Kishangarh would be urban slum. Then in Malviya Nagar, we've got a unit where we've adopted an Afghan refugee group. So we train them, skill them to do the training them in the stitching skills and then get work for them there. They have this inherent beautiful art of crocheting. So we help them design products which includes crocheting and stitching put together and help them develop a product which is marketable. So we make this beautiful hand crocheted jewelry, and you can see I'm flaunting one of them. And we have these beautiful earrings that we make, hand crocheted bags that we make.
प्रॉब्लम तो बस थोड़ा लैंग्वेज की प्रॉब्लम है इनके साथ, बाकी मुझे 1.5 साल हो गया है इन लोगों के साथ काम करते करते। अब तो थोड़ा कंफर्टेबल लगने लगा मुझे भी, लैंग्वेज भी इनकी समझ में आने लगी है, मैं भी समझने लगी हूँ इनकी बात को और ये लोग भी मुझे समझने लगे हैं।
सबसे तरफ से कह रहे कि हमको बहुत शुक्रिया करना है कि जब हम यहाँ पर इंडिया पे आ गए, क्योंकि हमारे जो अफगानिस्तान जो हमारे देश है वहाँ पर लड़ाई बहुत ज़्यादा था, लेकिन अब इंडियन लोग हमको यहाँ पर पना दिया और हमसे बहुत अच्छा तरह से बिहेव किया और हम सबसे शुक्रिया करते। और जो आप लोगों के सेंटर, हम यहाँ पर आके हमको सिलाई नहीं आता था, लेकिन आप लोगों हमको सिखा दिया और ये हमारे लिए बहुत बड़ा कुछ है, क्योंकि हम आए फ्यूचर में ये सिलाई करके कुछ हम कमा सकते हैं और हमारे बच्चों के लिए कुछ कर सकते। इसलिए इन सब लोग आप लोगों से बहुत थैंक यू कहना चाहती है और सब लोग बहुत खुश है इस बात से।
वी आर ऑलवेज इन नीड ऑफ हेल्प एंड एनी असिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ ट्रेनिंग और प्रोवाइडिंग फंड्स फॉर ट्रेनिंग and providing any help for marketing these products, because every year the number of women that we have grows, and we really do not know where all to approach, who all to approach. So any guidance would be really, really helpful, and I'm really thankful to IFN19 for having us covered and putting our story to a wider platform, so that, you know, people are more conscious and ready to help.